This antique-looking instrument is a barometer, specifically a 14 barometer. It measures atmospheric pressure and can be used to predict weather changes. This long tube, highlighted in red, has mercury in it. The top of the tube is sealed and the bottom end is submerged in a pool of mercury. Air molecules constantly collide with the surface of this pool of mercury with a downward force. This leaves the mercury with nowhere to go but up the tube. If the atmospheric pressure increases, the surface of the pool of mercury experiences a greater force, and the height of the mercury in the tube increases. If atmospheric pressure decreases, as it does right before a storm, then the mercury level in the tube drops. Atmospheric pressure measurements are made by carefully measuring the height of the mercury in the tube. To make a measurement, the ruler used to gauge the height must be calibrated. By turning this knob at the bottom of the device, the surface of the mercury is adjusted so that it is barely touching this pointer. Once that is set, readings can be made using gradations on a brass scale. The first three significant figures are read directly from the brass scale. 600 and 45 tor. An additional digit can be determined using a vernier scale. The vernier cursor is adjusted so that it is level with the mercury meniscus. The tenths place digit is determined by the pair of lines that match up most closely. Right now, the reading is giving us 645.4 tor. Our measurement isn't right just yet. Several factors cause an offset to the reading. For one, mercury slightly expands as temperature increases. That changes the height of mercury we measure, causing an error in our readings. The same is true for brass. That's why there's a thermometer right on the front of the apparatus. This temperature should be read as soon as approaching the device, since your body heat could change the reading. A less obvious problem is that gravity is not uniform across the Earth's surface. It changes slightly depending on your altitude and latitude. Now let's do the math to account for these problems. Using this equation, we can correct the measured pressure of 645.4 tor for the systematic errors we've been discussing. The result of this calculation is a corrected pressure of 642.7 tor. Although barometers have been used for centuries, today, the toxicity of mercury has caused some countries to legislate a halt to production of mercury barometers. High-quality pressure measurements are now achieved using sophisticated electronic circuits. However, a simple circuit like the one in my cell phone can use electrical components to measure pressure as well. At the time the barometer readings were taken for this video, my phone had a pressure reading of 642.5 tor. That's within 0.03% of the corrected barometer reading. Not too bad for such a small device, and my phone doesn't even have to have a tube of mercury.